Hello everyone, welcome to the channel Appychip. We hope you must be learning various new things every day. Today, we will learn about RabbitMQ Exchange Federation. Yes, you must have heard about RabbitMQ lots of times as a message broker tool. So, what it is exactly? Let's learn. So, RabbitMQ is generally being used when there are two loosely coupled systems. One wants to generate data at its own pace and second system wants to consume the same data at its own pace. To handle such kind of scenario, we put a middleware between both the system, and that middleware will hold the data so that consumer can consume from it and producer will produce the data and put it over there. So such tool is RabbitMQ. You can put RabbitMQ in between and producer will produce the data and put the data in the RabbitMQ and consumer can read same data from the RabbitMQ itself. So both the system can run independently also at its own speed. So this is the one advantage we get after putting a RabbitMQ system in between the loosely coupled systems. One more advantage RabbitMQ gives is high availability, since we can run RabbitMQ in a cluster mode. Even though your producer are down for some time, your consumer can get the data from the RabbitMQ itself. And since RabbitMQ itself is running in a cluster mode, even though if RabbitMQ one node is down, the whole cluster will be up for you, for your consumers. So that's the advantage of putting RabbitMQ. So here we will learn about one feature of a RabbitMQ called federation. So where this feature is being used and what are its use cases, let's learn. So one of its use case is collect messages from multiple cluster to a central cluster. So for example, your business is running at multiple geographical locations. So you have set up multiple clusters of RabbitMQ at multiple geographical locations, but your consumer bees at one place only. So if your consumer wants to consume data from multiple RabbitMQ cluster, they will suffer latency for sure. So what you can do is you can you can get all the data, all the messages of from all the cluster and put it into the central cluster of RabbitMQ where your consumer resides. So you can do this via federation. So what federation will do is will take the messages from all the cluster and will put it into the central cluster. Second use case is distributing load of one queue to the multiple cluster. So for example, in this case, if your cluster, if your consumer are at different locations and if you have one queue where data is being pushed, so what you can do is you can put multiple queues at multiple cluster wherever your consumer resides and put the same messages over all the cluster. So yes, federation gives that facility as well, so that you can publish same message at multiple clusters, so that you consumers can publish from the respective clusters. Third use case is migrate data from one cluster to the another without downtime. So for example, you have one RabbitMQ cluster and you want to migrate your whole data to the second RabbitMQ cluster. What you can do is you can set up federation between both, so all the messages that are being produced on the one cluster will be federated to the second cluster. So you won't have any downtime and your messages will get shifted to the second cluster. And afterwards, you can change the pointing of the cluster and your whole data will be at the second cluster. That's how you can migrate. Fourth is reduce latency for message consumption. So it is same like you can set up the RabbitMQ cluster where your consumers are instead of where your producers. So being your producers at various location, you can consume data without latency by setting up a local RabbitMQ cluster where your consumer resides and setting up a federation. So these all are the use cases of RabbitMQ federation. You can get the same data in our post on the Appychip blog post. You can find the link for the same post in the comment section of this video. So since there are two concepts in a RabbitMQ, first is exchange, second is queue. So whenever a producer produces a message, it first goes into the exchange and exchange puts that message in respective queues. From that queue, consumer consumes the data. So first message arrives in the exchange, and then it goes to the queue. According to you have set up the rule on the exchange, then from the queue, consumer consumes the data. So that's why you can set up two types of federation, called exchange federation and queue federation. Let's understand it one by one. First is exchange federation. So with exchange federation, it is possible to distribute messages to the other cluster. So it means, like, if your producer is producing a message in one cluster and your customer, for example, if your producer is producing data in Singapore and you have one cluster set up in the Singapore, but your consumers are in Singapore as well as India. So what you can do is you can set up two clusters, one in India and one in Singapore, and let producer produce the data and put it in the only in the Singapore cluster. And what you can do is you can set up a federation so that same messages will also be available in the Indian RabbitMQ cluster, so that both the consumer in the India and Singapore can access the same messages without the latency. So it means exchange federation, what it does is it duplicates the data and provides the messages. Where in queue federation, queue federation does intelligent load balancing. So it is useful to manage the load between your servers. For example, it won't duplicate the data. So if you have two clusters of RabbitMQ and you have consumer both the sides, what RabbitMQ will do is it will put half messages in the first cluster, and via federation it will send half of the data in the second cluster, so that both the consumers can consume the data and your data will be consumed at the faster rate. And if by chance your consumer on the second RabbitMQ cluster dies, it won't send the data there. It will only send the data on the first cluster. So it does intelligent load balancing and it doesn't duplicate the data. So this you can achieve via queue federation. So here we will learn about exchange federation. So these are the two types of federation. Now let's go through the terminologies. So since we there in the federation, we minimum have two cluster to set up the federation. So one is upstream server. So where upstream server is the server where your producer is actually producing the data. And downstream server, there is second terminology called downstream server. So downstream server is the server where you want to send the messages from the upstream server. So there will be two servers. So here in the AWS, I have created two servers. One is upstream RabbitMQ server and second is downstream RabbitMQ servers. So here is my management console for the same. This is my upstream RabbitMQ server and this is the downstream RabbitMQ server. So whatever data will be published here will automatically be replicated in the second downstream server. So let's go through it. So for this you must be ready with the three prerequisites. One is two RabbitMQ cluster, second is your management plugin enabled so that you can access this dashboard what we are seeing here, and third one is this port 15672 port open between both the servers so that they can communicate over it. Here I have set only single node cluster for the both cluster. So I have only one node cluster for the upstream server and one node cluster for the downstream server. So let's begin how to set up it. So first we have to create a user. So that user we will use for specifically federation. So this thing you have to do on both the servers, upstream servers and downstream server. So let's start with the downstream server. This is my downstream server. Let's go in admin panel. In the user, let's add a user. Federation user. Let's put the password as same. let's give the management tag. So, and let's add the user. Here our user has been added. Since I am logging with the guest user, let me give the access. I'm logged in with the guest user and I have created one more user called Federation user. Let's create now a virtual host. Let's call this test rehost. So RabbitMQ provides by default one user and one vhost created. So we saw one user guest and slash is the default vhost created by RabbitMQ. And now we have created test vhost. Let's give access of this vhost to our user. So Federation user, it will have all configure, write and read access of this vhost. Let's give our guest user also through which I am logged in so that I will be able to set up. So I have given both the users to access of this vhost. One is Federation user which will be required to set up Federation, and guest user is what which through which I have logged in. So these two users I have been given to the access to this vhost, test vhost. Now we have to create, so we have created a user, we have created a vhost, and we have given access. Now we have to create an exchange. So let's go on the downstream server, let's go in the exchange tab. So these are all the default exchanges created by RabbitMQ. Let's create a new exchange. Since we are going to use vhost, test vhost. So test vhost is a vhost in which our queues and exchanges will reside to which we want to federate. So if you have already vhost created and exchange created and queue created, you don't have to do all these things. Since this is my new setup, that's why I need to set up this. Otherwise, only you have to set up federation thing. So let's give the name test federation. Test exchange. Since this is the exchange, it will be durable inside the test vhost. Add exchange. So as you can see, this is our exchange got created. Now we have to create a queue. So from that exchange, all the data will be transferred to this queue. So let's create a queue. The same host, test vhost, name will be test_queue. Let's add it. Now we have to set up a binding so that all the messages that are arriving in our test exchange queue should come here. So we have to do a binding here. Let's add a binding from exchange, test_exchange. Bind. So all the messages which will come to the text exchange will automatically arrive here. So we have done with our binding. So we have our exchange and queue setup done. Now we have to create a policy. Let's go through here till where we have completed. So we have created an exchange, we have created a queue, we have binded the queue with the exchange. So till here, like, we have created a vhost, we have created a user, we have created a queue, we have created an exchange. So this all four things you have to do on both the server, that is upstream server and the downstream server, so that both the queues and exchanges will be present on the both the servers and users also will be presented on both the servers. Now, the rest of the setup you have to only do in the downstream server. So we have done till the exchanges part, we have done on the downstream server, and I have kept exchanges and queue ready in my upstream servers already. So I have here my user federation user ready. I have my queue ready. And I have my exchange ready here. So now the federation setup, we only have to do on the downstream server. So let's go on our downstream server and set up now. So first we have to do, we have to create a federation upstream. Since it is our downstream server, we have to tell which will be our upstream server so that from where we have to fetch the data. So let's create a new upstream. An upstream will be in test vhost server. Our upstream name will be the Federation Exchange. So let's create a federation upstream. The URI of this upstream will be in the form of MQ protocol, our federation user. And the password. So we have to give user name, then colon, then password. Then let's copy it from here. So our URL will be AMQP protocol, then federation user username, then our password federation user @ the IP of the IP or DNS of our upstream server, port name 5672, then our test vhost, or the vhost in which we are setting it, this federation. So this our vhost is test_vhost. So let's put it here. And let's change this IP with our upstream IP. Our upstream server is this. Let's copy it. Let's put it on the So we have set up this. Now we have to add it. So we have our federation upstream setup. So we have given it URI as well. Now we are done with our federation upstream setup. Now we have to create a policy. So this policy will tell to which exchanges we have to federate. So let's add a policy on the test vhost only. Policy name will be federation policy. Now we have to give a pattern of our exchange, what will be the pattern of our exchange on which this policy will be put. So whatever rejects we will do and whatever it will matches to, all that exchanges will get federated. So here our exchange name is test_exchange. So this rejects will says like any exchange which has name which has a pattern of test underscore exchange will get fed weight. This policy will apply to exchanges and queue. And let's add the definition of federation upstream set. And we have to put it all. You can provide it here, like from which upstream only you want to get the data. You can provide it here. Since we have only one, we are putting all. You can restrict like from which upstream you want to get the data here. Let's add this policy. So this policy should get should automatically get reflected on our exchange, since this pattern will match to our exchange. Let's see. So yeah, this test exchange, this policy will get applied. So since this regex is getting match, so we have applied it. Now our federation upstream setup has been done. We have created policy. Now let's see what our status of federation. In the federation status tab, you can see the federation status. It is saying that federation upstream is running. So now our federation setup is done. So if you will send any message on the exchange on the upstream server, you will get the data on our downstream RabbitMQ cluster. So as you can see on our upstream server, you can see like one more exchange called federation is getting created automatically with the type X federation upstream that we have set up on our downstream server. So this been created automatically whenever a federation got set up. Now this is my upstream server. Now let's try to publish a message here. So as you can see in the overview here, there are no messages. And also you can see in the overview, there is no messages. Let's see on the downstream server as well. In the overview, here no messages are available. So let's go on upstream server and let's try to publish one. Text exchange. You can publish data from here and also from the code. So let's test data, publish. Your message has been published. Now let's check in our queue whether it got published in our queue as well. So here you can see like in the upstream server only, in the test queue it has been arrived since we have put in the binding from the exchange. So it has been arrived here. Now let's see, this message has been arrived in our downstream server as well or no. So you can see in the overview tab, one message has been arrived. There is the count of one message. Let's see in the queue as well whether this message has been arrived. Hooray, we are on our downstream server. Also this message has been arrived. So we have set up federation, exchange federation successfully. So you can get all the steps in our blog post as well. You can refer here as well for link and all. So we hope you like this video. Please like and subscribe to keep us motivated. Keep learning, keep sharing.